This week on Cougar Media News.
Learn more about where students are attending college.
Get an inside look at the start of spring sports.
And now take a look at the new principles of education class.
Cougar Media News starts now.
Good morning, PHS. This is Emelia Kerr.
And Carmen McConaghy back with this week's episode of Cougar Media News.
Students had an opportunity to spend their prime time at the Caring Cupboard. Staff members Kaylee Van Kirk, Haley Wallacey, and Cage Jones are here to give us more information.
There are many students at PHS that have found ways to get involved in their community. One opportunity is helping out at the Caring Cupboard during prime time.
Students at PHS joined Mr. English to help break down boxes, organize products, unload food, and more. We got the opportunity to go to this prime time and talk to students and staff who got involved.
We started prime time. We were trying to find activities for students to do that was a little bit different than your normal study halls and things of that nature. So we knew we wanted to volunteer, so we reached out to Caring Cupboard, and they were happy to have us go, and the rest is history.
Students can get involved by filling out the travel form from the library and going onto the Caring Cupboard website and filling out that form and then signing up for the prime time.
We also got the chance to talk to another student that enjoys participating in this prime time opportunity.
My name is Lucas Fernandez and I participate in the Caring Cupboard prime time. They usually have us do stuff like move boxes from place to place, stock shelves. Sometimes they have us clean like the floors, the bakery, the kitchen, and generally anything that the Caring Cupboard head has us do. I decided to sign up because I thought it was a good use of my prime time. I don't usually have a lot of schoolwork to do, so I thought that doing the Caring Cupboard would be a very good way to give back to my community.
If you would like to get involved or to get more information, feel free to reach out to Mr. English. This is Kaylee Van Kirk,
Haley Wallacey,
and Cage Jones,
reporting for Cougar Media News.
Talk to Mr. English to sign up for this activity during prime time if you are interested.
Spring sports are officially in full swing. Ben Bell and Lauren O'Brien spoke to some of the players about the upcoming season.
The 2023 spring sports season is well underway at PHS as teams started their first in-season practice on Monday, March 6th. We talked to some of the athletes about what their team has done during the offseason to prepare for this season.
To prepare for the season, we have been doing a lot of open gyms.
We've had, ever since November and starting up here, ending here this month, we've had winter workouts.
A lot of us played in a winter league at the Nook, and we got to see a lot of good competition.
We've done multiple things to prepare for this upcoming season, including 6 a.m. practices on Saturday, stick stills and concept Tuesday and Thursdays, and Monday and Wednesday lift.
During the winter season, I know each event like has had individualized like training with each of their coaches.
Most teams all have one big goal that they work towards to achieve at the end of the season.
Our goals are to replicate what we did last season. We lost a lot of our starters from last season.
To definitely like make districts.
To make it to districts.
We want to be division champions.
We want to make it out of the first round of districts.
Are to return to districts and states as a team.
To be able to work together well and grow as a team throughout the season.
Rivalries are a huge part of high school sports. We asked some of the athletes which schools they are looking forward to playing the most this upcoming season.
I'm looking forward the most to play Lower Dauphin.
The team we always look forward to play, obviously, is Hershey.
Mechanicsburg this season, since they're a very tough team.
I'm looking forward to playing Mechanicsburg. They have some really good girl throwers.
I think definitely CD East. I think they'll be our biggest opponent this year.
Good luck to all the spring sports teams this season.
This is Ben Bell.
And Lauren O'Brien.
Reporting for Cougar Media News.
Wishing all the spring sports team luck as their seasons begin.
Morgan Salas, an art club member, is participating in the Rain Barrel Painting Contest. Lizzie Sampedri, Katie Hartman, and Ruby Carnwell are here to give us some more information on this event.
This year, art teachers Mrs. Vagnarelli and Mrs. Rossi made the decision to involve PHS in a rain barrel painting competition.
The rain barrel competition is being put on by the Lebanon County Conservation District. It is through students 9th through 12th grade, and they are having students paint rain barrels. They will be judged by the community at the plant sale at the Lebanon Valley Expo Center.
Senior Morgan Salas is the student who's representing Palmyra with her work, going against students 9th to 12th grade from across Lebanon County.
The concept behind the rain barrel was adapting to climate change. I am really enjoying painting it. It's really stressful though, because I only realized that I wanted to do and like participate in the competition last month. So coming up with the sketches and designs and having to prep the barrel and do everything and have it due by the 31st of this month, it's been a lot, but I'm enjoying it. What made me want to do this was because they were just sitting in the classroom for a while and I was like, that would be cool, so I did it.
Barrels will be judged by community members at the LCCD tree sale on April 7th from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. Monetary prizes will be given to the top three winners. Good luck, Morgan. This has been Ruby Cornwell,
Katie Hartman,
and Lizzie Zampedri
reporting for Cougar Media News.
Thanks, guys, and good luck, Morgan. Now over to Lauren O'Brien with this week's Now You Know.
Hi, PHS. Minithon is 1 week away. Today, I'm here with Mrs. Kowalczyk to give us some last-minute tips and tricks on how to prepare for the event.
Okay, so registration closes on Monday. Make sure that you are registered by Monday the 27th. You can pay up until the 31st. You can bring me a cash or check or with donor drive. For the day of, make sure that you wear comfortable shoes. You might want to put on some deodorant because it's going to be hot and sweaty. Bring a sweatshirt because we're going to be outside doing turf games, and be prepared to have fun and eat some good food.
Now you know.
I'm really looking forward to Minithon.
Me too.
It's the time of year where the seniors are making their post-graduation plans. Lizzie Zampedri, Katie Hartman, and Ruby Cornwell found out where PHS students are headed after high school.
Hartman.
And Ruby Cornwell.
And today we're going to be walking around and seeing what people's plans are after high school. Who am I here with?
Richie Dune.
Richie, what are your plans after high school?
My plans are to go to Penn State and major in sports marketing and business.
Awesome. Who am I here with?
Kaylee Brown.
Kaylee, what are your plans after high school?
I plan to attend Penn State and major in psychology.
Thank you. Who am I here with?
Ben Bell.
Ben, what are your plans after high school?
I'm attending Millersville University and majoring in media arts production.
Thank you. Who am I here with?
Gavin Clark.
Gavin, what are your plans after high school?
Attending Millersville University.
What are you majoring in?
Undecided.
Thanks. Who am I here with?
Shay Funk.
Shay, what are your plans after high school?
I plan to go into film, be a director or be a writer, maybe producer.
Awesome, thank you. This is Katie Hartman.
And Ruby Cornwell.
Reporting for Cougar Media News.
Congrats to graduating seniors and best of luck with your future endeavors.
Gabby Machinga, Kaylee Neuber, and Rowan Facciani are here with this month's Student Spotlight.
Student Spotlights features students that participate in activities outside of the school setting. We met with Isaiah Rohrer to learn more about his business.
My name is Isaiah Rohrer and I run a mobile detailing business. I started in the summer and we're kicking up back here in the spring.
We asked Isaiah how many vehicles he has detailed so far.
Over a dozen probably, maybe 20. I wanted to do something where I didn't have to like report to someone. I kind of wanted to be my own boss, so I decided I wanted to start my own business. And I like cars, so that's the profession I picked. We go to the customer's house and then we perform the detail at the house and then we pack up and leave. I do work with a partner. I work with one or two depending. Liam Weber and Camden Lynch are my two employees. For just the inside, it ranges from around 100, and for the exterior, it goes from like 60 to 100. We're on Yelp and Instagram, and we also have our own website. On Instagram, it's at Rohrer Mobile Detailing, and the same thing on Yelp.
This has been Kaylee,
Gabby,
and Rowan
reporting for Cougar Media News.
Choir had the opportunity to perform at the Capitol Building last Wednesday, the 15th. Lucas Fernandez, Amanda Gettle, and Tori are here to recap this event.
We'll be joined.
Last week, on Wednesday, March 15th, the high school concert choir went to the Harrisburg Capitol to perform songs in the rotunda. We got to speak to Mrs. Farrell to learn more about this trip.
The Capitol is a great place to perform the music that we choose each year. The acoustics are fantastic. The ambiance of the space is something that you can't replicate unless you're going to a church that has a huge cathedral. Just having that ambiance is the best way to perform some of the pieces that we have. My favorite song was probably Christus. It was a Renaissance piece that was written specifically for that rotunda ceiling.
The whole choir got to go perform as well as chamber choir, which is an auditioned choir group, as well as the middle school audition group, Cougar Noise. We spoke to Mr. Kurtz, who is the director of chamber choir, about the trip.
So it's Music in Our Schools Month, which is a time for ensembles to go perform at the Capitol to help support music. It represents an opportunity to show how fantastic the music program here at Palmyra is. The Aubin lead was written for that sort of space, and it's just beautiful, the overlap and harmonies and the way he wrote that. Really hard to beat in that kind of space.
This was an amazing experience for these students, as well as parents and other pedestrians who stopped by to watch.
This has been Lucas Fernandez,
Amanda Gettle,
and Tori Hepler,
reporting for Cougar Media News.
Great job, guys. Now over to Jacob Rudy with this week's sports update.
PHS, this is Jacob Rudy with this week's sports update. We will start with the end of the winter postseason. This past weekend, Elise Potter competed at the AAA State Diving Championships. Elise finished 19th to finish off the season. Congratulations. In girls wrestling, Riley Zettelmeyer competed this past weekend at the Keystone State Championships. Riley finished the weekend 3-2 and finished 7th overall. In boys wrestling, Jason Albright also competed at the Keystone State Championships and finished the weekend 4-1 and finished 4th overall. Congratulations to both wrestlers on a great performance. Now on to the start of the spring sports season. The baseball team had their two scrimmages against State College and Hamburg. The team defeated State College 9-2 and lost to Hamburg 6-2. Good luck to the baseball team today as they take on Hershey at home. The boys lacrosse team scrimmaged Warwick last week and then competed at a tournament in Downingtown East. The boys lost all three games against Downingtown East, Boyertown, and Downingtown West. They turned it around, however, to start the regular season with a 10-9 win over Exeter Township. The girls lacrosse team started their season last Friday by defeating Danville by a score of 13-7. The team then played State College this past Monday, winning in a dominant performance 16-2. Good luck to both the boys and girls lacrosse teams today as they both take on Chambersburg. The softball team scrimmaged Northern Lebanon last week, losing by a score of 5-2. The team will start their regular season today against Hershey. Good luck to the softball. The boys tennis team has had three matches so far. The team lost to Hershey 3-2, beat Lower Dauphin 3-2, and then lost to Cumberland Valley 3-2. The track and field team will compete at the Tim Cook Invitational this weekend. Good luck to all the athletes competing. They will start their regular season next week when they take on Lower Dauphin. The boys volleyball team will start their season next week against Lower Dauphin. Good luck to the volleyball team as they start the season. That's all we have for you this week, PHS. Now back to the desk.
Thanks, Jacob, and now for a commercial break.
Is that bag for the outreach drive? How do I donate?
Follow me.
You can donate items to room 119, Mrs. Yesko, or room 124 to Mrs. Broderick. For Key Club hours or NHS hours, donate to Mrs. Mateer or Mr. Machia.
If you are interested in donating items, drop them off in Mrs. Broderick's room 124. After school on Monday, March 20th, three teachers ended up with a pie in the face. Mrs. Smith, Mr. Showalter, and Mr. Thomason were selected as the lucky recipients, all to support Caitlin Smiles, an organization that encourages students with serious health challenges to explore their uniquely creative talents by taking part in arts and craft activities. Josh Moyer and Jacob Rudy were here to catch the action.
Key Club held a fundraiser for Caitlin Smiles, an organization that pays for activities for children in the hospital. Students could pay for tickets for the chance to pie a teacher in the face. Three teachers were chosen: Mrs. Smith, Mr. Showalter, and Mr. Thomason. Josh and I got the chance to cover the event. We interviewed the teachers who were selected.
Well, you can't see anything, first of all.
because the pie. And then you open your eyes and you can't see anything. But for Caitlin's smiles, anything is worth it. And so getting pied, definitely worth it.
I think it's awesome. It's for a great cause, and I'm happy to do it.
Mr. Thomason felt he deserved to get pied in the face.
My opinion would be pied. I think it's for a good cause, and if there's anybody in the school that's going to be pied, it should probably be me.
This has been Jacob Rooney and Josh Moyer reporting for Cougar Media News.
Thank you to all the students who donated to this fundraiser, and thank you for the teachers for being pied.
This year, PHS introduced a new class called Principles of Education. Staff member Annabella Mason investigated more about this class and what students learn.
Are you interested in being in the teaching field? Palmyra Area High School provides a new course called Principles of Education. This course gives students the opportunity to practice teaching and learn what goes into education.
This class has helped me gain a better understanding of what it's like to be an educator. It takes a lot of time in and outside of school. It's helped me gain a better opinion of what I wanted to do. It's really helped me narrow down whether I want to be a teacher or not.
This course was introduced to PHS this school year.
This is the first year that it has actually been put into the scheduler system of Palmyra.
Students learn a variety of teaching skills and roles that a teacher plays in and out of school.
I have learned classroom management skills. I've learned various techniques of handling conflicts with parents and other teachers. I've learned the six roles of a teacher, how it's important that teachers need to be resource developers, they need to be good assessors.
Principles of Education teaches the basics of teaching and is an important elective to take if you are interested in the field.
This class is very important because you know the basics of teaching. It's very important to learn how to be a teacher and what it means to be a teacher.
I feel like anyone who wants to go into the education field or wants to work with children, I think it's a good option for them because then it will let them see what it takes in a day or what it takes to teach. It's different characteristics of children and what works best for different age groups.
It's very light work, but you learn a lot. It prepares you a lot for college and the path to teaching.
Make sure to talk to your guidance counselor if you're interested in taking this class. This is Annabella Mason reporting for Cougar Media News.
If you were interested in this class, talk to your counselor or Mrs. Dellinger. Maddie McKee and Rowan Facciani tested how well two PHS students know their music.
Timber Pitbull featuring Kesha. September, Earth, Wind, and Fire. I'd like to call him something. I think
I'll just call it a day. 5 o'clock somewhere, Alan Jackson.
Boyfriend, Big Time Rush.
I listened to Big Time Rush a day in my life, nor will I ever.
Rachel, and don't forget, only 1 week until Minithon.
That's all we have for you this week, PHS. Have a great weekend.
Tumble out of bed and I stumble to the kitchen. Pour myself a cup of ambition and yawn and stretch and try to come to life. In the shower and the blood starts pumping. Out on the streets the traffic starts jumping. With folks like me on the job from 9 to 5. Work